Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 75 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. I can't believe we're already on episode 75. That's a really crazy number to me. That's really kind of crazy, I think. I'm just throwing some more ME stuff in my system. Yeah, 75, that's like a hugely crazy number. But luckily, we've got a lot of content still to come. There's a lot of mods that I haven't even touched yet, a lot of mechanics I haven't looked at yet. So I feel like this season's probably going to last a little while longer, at least probably until, hopefully, the 1.7 mods are already in public, and maybe there won't be a very large gap between the 1.6 Let's Play series and the 1.7. But, you know, I can't make any promises. You never know what's going to happen. So without any further rattling on, what are we going to work on today? Good question. I'm glad you guys asked. Let's see. Is my golden lasso in here somewhere? I need to pick up that sheep and put him back where he belongs. I would like to maybe start looking at a new mod that we haven't played with just yet this season, or actually much at all. It's probably time to start looking at Witchery. That's right. I want to check out Witchery. I know I played with it a little bit on ForgeCraft 1, but I would definitely like to start playing with it in my Let's Play series here, where I can kind of, you know, use a lot of different mechanics and try and put together a lot of cool stuff. So what I'm going to do is start getting into the basics of Witchery. I'm going to show you guys how it works, introduce you to it for those of you who haven't really seen it before. There is a mod spotlight up on it that kind of goes through it all, but we're going to go through it all in a legit playthrough world. Obviously, in my ForgeCraft series, I tend to move a little bit more quickly and try and, you know, cruise through stuff and, you know, build crazy things. On here, I'm going to move through it and just make sure you guys understand all the mechanics and see how everything works. So, yeah, let's get started playing with Witchery. First things first, where do I want to play with Witchery? That's a good question. The Witchery stuff should be done in kind of like a outdoorsy kind of area, a nice open glade with lots of different plants and materials around. So I think what I'll do, I mean, I know we have this like magical forest over here. That might not be a terrible spot. We've got, you know, the cherry biome over here. That might not be a terrible spot. So there's a lot of different places where we could kind of go look around and try and, you know, think of something cool to do. But, you know, I don't want it to be too far away from my house. So we're going to have to kind of look around and see where a good spot would be. If I find someplace really good, I'll plant down there. But the main focus is you need a lot of plants nearby just to power all your magical stuff that we're going to be doing. I mean, I could kind of do it like right over here near this big volcano, but we'll see. I mean, this area is kind of open. I haven't really done much over here except for that activation ritual, which, wow, that is just a mess of a landscape right there. So we'll see. Let me start looking around, figure out a good place, and then I'll be back to get started messing around with Witchery. All right, guys, the first thing I'm going to really need to get if I want to do a crazy amount of Witchery here, well, one of the first things I should get is get some repairing going on in this axe of the stream. But aside from that, I'm chopping down this giant jungle wood tree that I found out here because I need a lot of different saplings. So basically, a lot of witchery involves a lot of natural magical effects, and you're going to need a lot of natural items to get this going. And I might break this thing. Oh, nice. All right, I better go get repair on this nifty little tool here. Let's see, how did I do? Did I get a lot of jungle saplings? I should have, because using the axe of the stream causes the leaves to fall a lot faster. And how did I do? Yeah, I did. I got some jungle saplings. Awesome. All right, let me go get this thing repaired up, and then I'll be back. You guys would not believe how hard it is to find spruce saplings in this world. Boy, oh boy, I've been looking around for like 20 minutes. That's right, I have a plan. So one of the first things we're going to want to build from Witchery, after I get out of my smeltery here, is something that's going to be useful for us to get started. There's actually a lot that we're going to need to do. Let me just clean up my inventory real quick. What I was doing was repairing my axe. I figured, hey, why not use this thing? It's been a while since I've had it going, so let the axe repair in there. And for now, I think we're ready to get started at least. So one of the things I want to start with is getting Mutandis. Mutandis is kind of your best bet for starting. It's one of the things that's going to give you access to a lot of the saplings and trees and stuff that you're going to need to really, you know, do what you need to do. In order for us to get Mutandis, though, there's a few things we need to get. First off, we need some mandrake root, which is something that we're going to grow. And then we're also going to need some wood ash and some hint of rebirth. Now, wood ash is pretty easy. You can just smelt any sapling and you'll get it, but you can also get it, I think, from a witch's oven, from any sapling, basically. So basically, you're going to want to do this in a witch's oven, because when you do it in the witch's oven, not only will you get the wood ash, but if you have some clay jars in there, you'll get this byproduct, depending on which sapling you're smelting. So what we want to do then is get some mutandis and start with the hint of rebirth. Now that, you're going to want to smelt saplings, spruce saplings to be specific. These are the only ones that give you hint of rebirth. So since I need wood ash and I need a hint of rebirth, I'm going to get myself a bunch of spruce saplings and start smelting them. Now each of the different saplings in a witch's oven can do different things, and you'll get different materials out of them if I can find the witch's oven. So for example, you'll get this exhale of the horned one from the oak saplings. So we're going to want all the different kinds of saplings pretty much available to us for the most part. Now let's see here. How am I for spruce saplings? Probably not as good as I would like to be. I've only got about half a stack, which is not that big a deal, but we want to make sure that we kind of have a decent amount of all types of saplings for this process. Now, the mandrake root, let's see, did I get any mandrake? No, I think that's the only plant that I didn't get. That'll just come from tall grass, so just go find yourself a nice tall grass spot, get yourself a sapling, and you're pretty good. So all I gotta do is run around here, and I'll find myself some mandrake. At least I hope I will. Tall grass, chop it down. See, there we go, mandrake seeds. Nice. So obviously there's a lot of planting and a lot of stuff to do with witchery. So that's kind of why I wanted to start working with that MFR planter over here. So I think we've got enough potatoes and probably maybe enough carrots. Not as much as I would have wanted, but that's okay. We're going to take a break from doing what we're doing over there, and we're going to actually move this whole planter setup for the time being. Let's get it transferred. Do I want to move it? Or do I want to actually, maybe I want a second one for saplings, because I'm basically going to need almost an entire planter set up for the trees that I'm going to want eventually. And I know there's going to be some plants as well that I want to get. So I think what I'm going to have to do here is create a new planter setup. So let's do that. We're going to want a planter, which is this guy. Oh, so close. I need a flower pot. Oh, good. I can make that. And then, of course, I want a harvester. Now, there's a big reason that I'm using this setup here, and I'll show you in a moment. Let's see. We're going to want an inbar axe, and we're going to want some shears. And we're going to want a redstone reception coil. And while we're at it, we can get some... Let's get some hardened energy conduits, some redstone energy conduits. Did I ever teach this guy how to make redstone energy conduits? Probably not. 36 of them. And it's 2 redstone per. So I'm just going to get this and this cooking. 100, 200, then it runs. See? Cool. So outside here, I actually prepped a little bit of an area to get going with the whole tree thing. So let's find a nice center area. I think like right here. I didn't really measure this out per se, but it should be sufficient. And we want our planter here. Cool. Now, the reason I'm using this planter is that I can use a filter to specify exactly what to plant where. I was trying to do this an episode or two back with the carrots and potatoes, but there was a bug in the version of Mine Factory Reloaded that we were using that basically caused this setup to fail. Like, it would just reset every time. I think either the server restarted or the chunk unloaded or something like that causes basically that thing to get reset, which is a problem for us, but it's not that big a deal, because I actually went ahead and updated my MFR version, and that's going to be updated automatically for you guys once we update to the version 22 of the Direwolf 20 pack. But if you guys are running version 21, just keep in mind that this might not work terribly well for you just yet. So one of the things we're going to want to get is oak. We want some spruce, and we're going to want some jungle saplings. Cool. And now that I've run around and done all that, perfect timing, got here just in time. So we're also going to want to get some power over here. Ooh, getting dark out. Don't want to do this at night. That would probably be a bad idea. Okay, so, like I said, this looks like a pretty decent thing. You know what else I want to do real quick while I'm here? is I want to grab those upgrades. I might even want like the top tier upgrade, but let's see. Do I have the sledgehammer? Did I throw that in my white bag, maybe? I know I made one, didn't I? Yeah, there it is. Cool. And let's get those upgrades. I know I made a couple of silver ones that have a plus 6 radius, but I'm thinking, what's the top tier? Radius negative 1 for cobble. That's funny. Emerald, radius increase of 11. All right, I think I should be able to pull that off. I just want to see like how crazy of a size we're talking about with an 11 block radius upgrade. Oh yeah, that's not bad at all. Look at that. If I just cleaned up a few things here, I could probably have a pretty ridiculous farm set up, and we'll have a ton, and I mean a ton, of saplings. All right, that's not too shabby. Let me clean up this area, make sure I've got enough room for this stuff all to grow and do what I want it to do, and then we'll be back. The only thing I'm going to want to do is grab this beehive here, and I, you know, don't want to destroy it the wrong way, so make sure to make yourself a scoop anytime you need to move a beehive. Yeah, we will be getting to bees eventually, don't worry. I know some of you really want to see bees, and other ones of you are just like, I hate bees, I don't want to see them. Don't worry, at some point we'll get to bees, and I'll try and do something really cool with them, so that at least, you know, those of you who have seen bees before are at least interested in it, but we're not getting to it just yet. Alright, that looks like a pretty darn good-sized farm. Alright, I'll take that. So let's get this guy started, shall we? So in order to get this thing going, we need some power. Let me run that off camera, because that's going to involve a lot of digging and stuff. Hey, there we go. We've got power hookup. Nice. So that's what I'm going to get started with. That's the first thing I'm going to install. What I want to do is define the areas that we want to plant these saplings. So the first three saplings I'm going to set up are the jungle and the spruce and the apple oak. So what's going to happen is, because I'm designating these on the red, yellow, and green areas, red, yellow, and green are over there. So the, you know, area is going to be divided up into 9 little sections, and it's going to plant all the apple oak saplings over there, it's going to plant all the spruce saplings over there, and it's going to plant all the jungle saplings over there. All it needs is some stuff to get started. Now I'm going to set consume stack to off, and we're going to do this, and you'll see that it's kind of doing what it's supposed to be doing. Maybe not. That's weird. It definitely doesn't seem to be behaving the way it should be. Yeah, let me take a look and see why that might be. Alright guys, I think I figured out the issue here. Let's take a look. I actually filled some dirt into the pattern slots because I didn't want those to fill just yet. So now, if I go ahead and toss these guys in here, we should get filled with the pattern that we expect. Now, it does go through like a sequence of filling the entire area. So it's going to like, I think it goes like down this row and then down this row. So it'll take a few seconds to populate, but you'll see that the spruce saplings are being kept in the area as defined. Cool. So we'll let those go, and while that's happening, I want to get ready with the sledgehammer to decide exactly where we're going to put the harvester, which is going to go right there, I believe. That sounds good. Sure. So harvester can go here. This is going to be a ridiculously large area, but that's okay by me. Go big or go home, right? And let me just run some power over to it. So the next thing I want to set up is make sure that this thing can be refilled, because we want to make sure that the first thing that happens is that the saplings make their way down here. So here's one little trick I'm going to do too. Check this out. If I come down here and I grab my hammer and we put this guy on vacuum mode, this will be the first destination for any items entering the pipe. So you can see I have consume stack mode off, so it'll always leave one apple, spruce, and jungle sapling in here. So that way, as these things are harvested, they'll automatically send the saplings down here, because the saplings will fit in the inventory, but anything else, like wood, will not. And any extra saplings won't fit either, because I filled the rest of the inventory with dirt. Now, as we get more and more saplings, we're going to want to do more and more with this. So this guy is ready to go, I think. Yeah, he's basically got power. We just need to specify. He's probably stuck because he doesn't have anywhere to put his junk. So let's make sure that we've got a spot for that. Trying to bait. I'm thinking I might want to go with a ender chest. Blue, blue, blue. That might be good. Ender chest. Do I have any blue wool by chance? I do have blue wool. Look at me. All prepared? That's not like me. So then it's just a matter of doing this and that. And then setting this guy to output mode, and items should flow. So all the wood is going to get stuck in here. See how it's harvesting all the trees and such? Apples will also do that, but look, the saplings are heading down because of vacuum mode. Even though the ender chest is a closer destination, vacuum mode is saying, hey, come to me first. Any items that can fit in this inventory, at least, should make their way over to here first. Awesome, right? So we'll let this thing run for a little bit and see how we make out. What we should wind up with is a surplus of spruce saplings, as well as all the other types of saplings. So we'll have probably a ton of, you know, apple saplings, of course. We've obviously got the wood farm over there, but I'm just trying to keep everything organized. Everything together can't hurt, right? So let's see. Did we get any more jungle saplings? That's the real trick, because jungle saplings can sometimes be a nuisance. I guess we'll find out. If we don't, then I'll just go harvest a few more with my newly repaired Axe of the Stream. Cool. We're also getting a bunch of sludge. Sludge can be used for a few cool things. Oh, look, we did get jungle saplings. Awesome. And we'll probably, you know, keep use of that maybe at some point. But for now, I think we've got a pretty good farm set up here. All right. Oak sapling. Oh, okay. That's neat. So you're making oak saplings, huh? All right. Instead of the forestry stack oak saplings. So because these are actually two different items, item ID 6 and item ID 13384, I'll put the regular oak sapling in here so that, you know, even though we have a ton of the, you know, forestry oak saplings, once this harvests the trees here, it might be an issue. We'll see. We'll see what happens when it chops it down. If you know, regular oak saplings are what's getting dropped in here, that's cool. I'll have to also then, of course, do that so that it's oak saplings that get planted. We'll see. All right, back in a few minutes. I'm going to let this run for a few and see how it makes out, and then we're going to build our witch's oven. All right, so I just set up a little test thingy here, and it appears I lied. It is apple oak saplings that we're getting, the forestry ones. Not sure how I managed to one stumble upon this guy, but we're going to take him out, and we're going to put this back in here and there. So now that this thing will work properly again. All right, back to vacuum mode with you. I just needed to test that to see if it was really apple oak saplings that we were getting or not. And we're not. Tricky, tricky. All right, there we go. So the regular old vanilla oak sapling for a reason. We'll go in there, and we'll let this thing run for a bit. Now let's get to a witch's oven. What do you say? Cool? So we'll just keep an eye on this. It looks like it's running properly. So the witch's oven, let's see, where do I want to set up my witchery environment? That's a good question. I think I have an idea of an area picked out. All we need is a little bit of iron. Shouldn't be too bad, and we get a witch's oven. Now this is pretty cool. The witch's oven actually can be updated if you want to get things to be a little bit more efficient, and I'll show you guys how to upgrade this guy. What you can do is add to it, I think it's called a smokestack or something like that. A fume funnel, that's what we're looking for. I'm not sure if we have the resources. It doesn't look too bad. Fume funnel, huh? So I'll show you guys what these fume funnels do in just a minute. But first, I want to pick out a place to call my witchery homeland. I think right over here on the other side of this river would be a nice spot. I wouldn't mind clearing out the terrain a little bit, kind of flattening it out, and getting it nice and prepared for what I want to do with it. I'm thinking this is good. Just want to kind of look around and see if there's anywhere that looks a little better. I mean, this is pretty nice. All right, guys, I don't think that looks too terrible, right? Cleared out a little bit of terrain here, flattened it out, made it look a little bit nice. Cool. So basically, guys, what I'm going to do is kind of start in the center here and build out. So the witch's oven, as mentioned, requires just a few things. And what's nice, you can just click on the arrow here to see the recipes. We're going to need clay jars, and we're going to need something to smelt with. So I'm thinking we can just grab some coal or even, you know, alumite or something like that. Or, yeah, you know what I mean, to get stuff going. So let's see. Alimentum, just for smelting purposes, and then we're going to want to get clay jars. Now, these guys are actually something we're going to want a lot of, so I'm going to teach my system how to make it down here. Clay jar. So in order to get this, we just need to smelt a soft clay jar, which is this little pattern right here. So soft clay jar, encode that. And we'll just put this in the page 2. Looks like we're getting kind of full in there. And then what I can do is request jars. And I'll just request 10 for now, just to get started. And then we can teach this guy. What I'll do is I'll put this in here. Got the first one. And just say, actually, one of you equals one of you. And it looks like we're actually getting to the point where we might need to get some more stuff here, but that's okay. So now all we need to do to request this, I'm going to get just a stack for now. So you can see it quickly turning the clay into clay jars, smelting them nice and quickly. Awesome. So now that we've got something to smelt with, and something to smelt, and some clay jars to store the captured essence in, I want to show you guys about the fume funnels. Fume funnels will increase the chance, not only does it increase the speed at which this thing cooks, but it also increases the chance of capturing fumes. You're going to want two of them, one on either side, and you can see them hooking into that thing pretty well. So these guys are actually pretty important to use, because without them, I want to say you have something like a 30% chance to get what you want to get, which is the fumes here. Now, if you go ahead and put one of these guys down, you get an additional 25% for each fume funnel. So that gets you pretty close to almost guaranteed. If you can also get, by the way, a filtered fume funnel, which is an upgraded version, that requires some more expensive stuff like a charged attuned stone, which we'll get to a little bit later, which we'll probably upgrade to. But with that, you get a 30% boost for each fume funnel. So if you have this fully upgraded, you get a 90% chance of getting your extra byproduct. But trust me, it's definitely worthwhile, especially early on when you're low on saplings. So we've got our two fume funnels here. We should have a pretty high chance of capturing that essence that we're looking for. See, we already got one. Hint of rebirth. Nice. That's much better than without these upgrades. Plus, they look awesome. So you can't go wrong. So we'll let this thing cook up. And while that's happening, I'm going to start looking at some of the plants that we're going to want to get. I'm thinking it's time to remove these plants over here. See you later, guys. I'm sorry, but you are done. Let me actually get down underground here. Yeah, because you're going to go ahead and repopulate, aren't you? Let's dig into here and just start changing stuff up. So we're going to want to actually take these all out of here and replace this with some of the stuff we're going to want to get for witchery. So let's find those seeds that we collected. We'll put you guys away. And we'll find seeds. So far I found myself a handful of water artichoke seeds, mandrake, belladonna, and snowbell seeds. Okay, so these guys are all pretty cool. There's just one thing we're going to want to keep note of, and let me actually get some bone meal so we can kind of start this process going. Bone meal, looking good. Might want a few more of these. Just get a stack's worth, that's cool. I've got enough bones where I don't really feel like I need to waste time pulverizing them. I know you can get more that way, but eh. All right, let's clean this area up. I don't even think I really need the pumpkins anymore, so we'll just kind of tidy everything. There we go, not too shabby. Okay, just get rid of this stuff, and we're good to go. So a couple things to note. First off, let's go look at planting in here. We're going to want to probably have, well, doesn't really matter. I'm going to have, let's see, water artichokes I'm going to maintain to one area, I think. So let's get some belladonna seeds going first. That should wind up going up there. Okay, cool. So that's the red going up here. Neat. Okay. We're definitely going to want more of these seeds. So let's see. That's a fully grown belladonna. And our harvester should be able to collect that guy and what we want it to do. Oh, nice, it did. Cool. Now, I'm trying to decide exactly how I want to set this up. I'm not sure if this planter is going to be able to plant the water artichokes. That's the one I'm a little concerned about. So why don't I get myself some buckets of water here? Make myself a quick infinite water source. I had one right here, too, and I said, I don't need this infinite water source here anymore. And then one episode later, oh yeah, I guess I do for a minute. Oh well. I'll put it here just to be different. See, I didn't need the one that was over there. I need it here now. So let's see. Can I get this guy to plant? That's the real question. So if we want that guy, it's going to be the green section that we want to plant water artichokes on. So let's see what happens. We'll give that a minute to run, and I'm going to grab the belladonna seeds that came out of here. Good, we got two of them. Oh, it planted some right here. That's kind of neat. So I guess, oh yeah, look at that, it is planting them. That's awesome. That's really good to know, actually. All right, cool. So we can let that do its thing. I'm actually going to also fill this in for a moment, just so I don't have to worry about it planting things where I don't want them to be. Snowbells I'll put here, and then I guess mandrakes we'll put here. Cool. And that looks good to me. You know what I might do? Because I'm kind of getting started here, it might not be a terrible idea to move this setup. These things should actually help out. Don't pick those up. All right, fine, pick them up. Cool. They'll wind up in my AE system down here. So give me a few minutes, guys. I'm going to kind of set this farm up the way I want it to operate, and then we'll be back. So yeah, there's one little problem with mandrakes. Ah! Whenever they get harvested, sometimes they turn into these things. And you have to actually kill them to get the mandrakes. And in the presence of killing them, nasty things tend to happen. So I'm going to have to automate that in some mystical, strange way. I haven't entirely figured out how I'm going to automate that yet. There's a couple ways we can automate mandrakes. I kind of want to do it in, you know, tune with the way the mod's meant to work. Like, probably a semi-cheaty, not very cool way to do it would be to say, alright, let's just capture one in his farinet and set him up in the MFR spawner. That would probably work, but I don't really want to do it that way, so I'm going to try and find a good, proper way to handle it. I've got an idea or two. So, we'll see. So then the last thing we really need to do here is set this thing up to keep, you know, so many items stacked. I'll say maybe like half a stack of each. That ought to be good, right? And then the extra seeds will just wind up in the system. But what's nice is we'll have just, you know, a bunch of the stuff eventually. So let's let these guys go, and then I think I have an idea. I might want to implement it now because mandrakes are one of the things we need pretty quickly. I didn't mean to click that. All right, guys, for now what I've done is disable the harvester with this lever here. When it's when the lever's off, it's allowed to run, but when the lever's on, it's in stasis mode. It just won't run. So I'm going to let the few plants that are planted here run for now, but what I'd like to do is build an automation system to handle the mandrakes. So mandrakes are going to be a little bit of a problem for us, but I think I have an idea on how to solve that problem. So why don't I get situated, and next episode we'll come back and deal with mandrakes. How are we going to automatically kill them and capture all the stuff they drop as plants. Good question. We'll find out next time. For now, I think it's time to wrap up the episode. So before we do that, let's go check on our harvesting over here. Everything seems to be working well. This guy should be in vacuum mode, which means he's pulling up all his items. Yes. And we've got a bunch of saplings in there. Obviously, jungle saplings we're a little short on because, you know, jungle saplings are not really great about dropping saplings. So, you know, if that becomes a problem, we'll just kind of have to deal with it. But everything else is running just fine. And we're actually getting a good surplus of spruce saplings. As you can see, we're almost at the full 64 stack. And once that's done, any extra spruce saplings will get sent to my AE system. Over here, our witchery setup, our witch's oven has done a good job. We got, you know, a pretty decent percentage. We've got 6 hints of rebirth. We've got 11 wood ash. So we got almost 50%, a little bit more than for the process here. Because of the fume funnels, that's definitely a worthy upgrade. So I think we've made out pretty well. What I'm going to do next episode is come back. Like I said, we're going to automate the collection of the mandrake root, and then we're going to start creating some of the items like Mutandis and some of the other stuff for witchery. So lots of infrastructure set up today, but all in preparation for all the witchery stuff we want to do. For now, Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Take it easy!